pacemakers keep the heart from going too slowly. A pacemaker is a small computer and a battery wrapped in a metal can. It's inserted under the skin but outside the chest cavity and has one or more wires that connect it via the veins to the various chambers in the heart. The wires allow the pacemaker to sense or see what the heart rhythm is doing, as well as to pace the heart to increase its rate. Pacemakers are used to keep the heart from going too slow, as well as to help coordinate the top and bottom chambers of the heart when the body's own electrical bridge isn't functioning correctly. If the heart rhythm is normal, they simply sit back and watch. However, the moment the heart rate drops or the signals from the top chamber aren't making it through to the bottom chamber, they kick in and prevent you from having a slow heart rate or heart rhythm. Not only can they keep the heart rate from going below a set rate, but they're actually smarter than that. They can be programmed to sense when you are active and moving, and just like our own natural pacemakers do, they can increase the heart rate further during periods of activity and slowly walk the heart rate back down as you rest. These and many other settings on the pacemaker are programmable and can be changed using a computer in our clinic at any time, even after you've healed up from the implant. Pacemakers themselves do not treat fast heart rhythms, but they do monitor and record them, and they also allow your physicians the ability to use medications to treat those fast rhythms that they otherwise couldn't use if you didn't have a pacemaker, for fear of making the heart rate too slow. Once implanted, we typically follow or check pacemakers every 3 months or so. However, you do not need to travel to our office for that. Fortunately, this can usually be done from the comfort of your own home using a monitor, which we will provide to you often before you leave the hospital. Pacemakers have batteries, and as such, the batteries eventually run low. They typically last close to 10 years, depending on how much they are being used. However, it's not like the battery in your TV remote in that it just suddenly stops working. Rather, the pacemaker actually alerts us when the battery is nearing time to change, and we then have several months to arrange for that to be done. When the time comes to change it, we technically don't just change the battery. We change the battery and computer unit, what we call the generator. But the wires typically do not need to be changed. Thus, you usually go home the same day as that procedure. A typical pacemaker initial implant involves bringing you into the hospital, where in the EP lab, we give you some medication to sedate you. You aren't completely under or on a breathing machine. Rather, we make you sleepy and comfortable so that you won't feel or remember anything. Then, we numb the skin and the area where the pacemaker goes on the chest. We make a small incision, and through that incision, place one or more wires into the vein. Via that vein, we pass the wire or wires down into the heart. The other ends of the wires are then connected to the pacemaker, and the pacemaker tucked in under the skin and closed up with stitches that will self-absorb. We typically keep you in the hospital overnight, and if all goes well with some testing the next morning, you are usually discharged to home the next day. You will have instructions before leaving the hospital on the do's and don'ts, including how to care for the incision and limitations on lifting and moving the arm on the side of the pacemaker. We will discuss the risks and benefits of your pacemaker implant in more detail in person, but briefly, the issues we are concerned about include infection, bleeding at the site, in the chest, or around the heart, as well as a collapsed lung.